Playing for Change unites a blind street singer from New Orleans, Native American drummers, South African choral singers, as well as musicians from a dozen other countries, ranging from Spain to Nepal. Grammy-winning producer Mark Johnson says he was struck by the power of music when he saw two monks performing on a New York City subway platform.
And on this day, I saw this amazing moment where 200 people or so stopped. Nobody got on the train. Everybody's watching this music, and some people are crying and jaw-dropping and smiling, and a collection of people who normally just run by each other, here they are, coming together for music in a language they don't even understand.
Johnson's first recording for the project was of a street musician in Santa Monica, California, singing Stand By Me. He then went around the world and, using a mobile recording studio, recorded 37 musicians singing the same song. Stand By Me was Playing for Change's first big hit. The video has been viewed on the internet more than 30 million times. Soon, Johnson had enlisted more than 100 musicians in the project and recorded a CD and a documentary DVD containing hits like One Love and Don't Worry. Titled Playing for Change, Peace Through Music, it sold over 26,000 copies in its first week. But important as music is to Playing for Change, Johnson says the organization's message is about more than music.
Playing for Change is a movement of people around the world who believe that with music we can inspire each other to come together. So in a world with so many divisions, Playing for Change is trying to create inspiring connections for the human race through music. It's been too
hard living. For the group's North American tour, Johnson put together a band of 10 musicians from 7 countries. Suriname soul singer Clarence Becker was raised in Amsterdam. He says it took a while to get adjusted to playing with musicians he did not know.
The first rehearsals, getting all the band together, it's a strange feeling, you know. You know, I was kind of a bit nervous. You don't know who's going to be in the band, if you're going to like these people or if you're not. From the first second we've been together, it's like we're one family.
Congolese musician Merman Skenkosenki says it is a privilege to be part of the band.
It's a dream coming true for me. In my country, they say music is the food of soul. But as a musician, it's a dream to be up there, to be able to spread your message. Let's make this world a better place for our children, for the future.
South African guitarist Louis Mlanga, who grew up in Zimbabwe, says Playing for Change is spreading an important message.
It's what the world needs. To open people's thoughts, to make them aware that there is love, peace, happiness, respect to be shared.
In addition to performing, Playing for Change has set up a foundation whose goal is to provide musical supplies and educational programs to poor communities around the world. So far, it has established music schools in South Africa, Ghana, and Nepal, and is working on a fourth one in Mali. Along with teaching young people the beauty of music, the schools are another way to spread the message of Playing for Change.
And I think that a project like this shows us that we can all come together, believe in each other, respect our differences, and celebrate our connections.
I'm Rali Rejsovic, VOA News, Washington.
Have his hand made the rain.